keep your kahoot.it on, you play the game. So you click on that and start playing. Okay, so one minute. Nine question, okay. So click start, we start. Okay, so now suppose you want to play this game. Okay, Zul, just go back. 1 minute, we show you how you play. Okay, it's playing this game. So you have a Kahoot created by somebody else, which is not you, it's just somebody else. You want to play the game, you just click play. Play. Okay. The Kahoot is global warming, it will load. And there are two types of modes for this. For example, I divided you all into three groups, and each one has only one phone. I divided you into one-to-one. So you have classic and team mode. So classic, usually classic. Just go for classic mode. Okay. Okay. Now the Kahoot will be ready. Wait for a while. Okay. Go to your Kahoot website, your kahoot.it, and you key in the PIN number. Okay. So... Okay. Let's see how many players. Okay, ready? How many? We see the number joining. You can join in. Okay, one player. We need more players. It will only play when two. Okay.
My name. No.
Three. Okay, all your names are coming. Okay, you ask you for any. Okay, four. But this is a very way you stop the class. This is used for assessment in the class, classroom assessment. You can bring your teaching conservation biology, you bring up that thing, different kinds of mushroom, or bird, there are Kahoot for that. Identify that, so you can bring it up in the class anytime randomly, and you can just display. Okay, so done. So four players. Anybody else wants to join? Four. Okay, start. You just click start. So you'll see questions coming out. Are you ready? Nine questions. So it asks you the first game. Okay, please. What is global climate change? You'll see the thing in your... Fast. Okay. You click on, you'll see a... you click the one which you feel is correct. You look like Domino's pizza. We got three answers. Okay, so you can see. Okay, so next question. Okay, you can see who's the score. Team board leader. So you go to the next question. Next. So the question two will come. There are nine questions, so you just answer all. Oh, four. Okay. Fast. Next. Everyone got correct, so it stopped. So the same question again. Once it finishes all, it gives automatically right ahead. Oh, there. Four. This is designed for basic. The next. Now, have you seen they staggered, so it become more difficult as it goes on. That's the Kahoot way of method, performative. Okay, they make it more difficult. Six, five. To increase global warming. Next question will be more difficult, I guess. So they'll ask a difficult. This is the difficult. So they have easy, difficult, easy. They slip. So they're testing. Of course, the last will be the most. It's an obvious answer. The obvious answer is not the correct. Which is the correct answer? Oh, the obvious one. Oh, okay. Okay. The remaining did not give. Next. Seven. Two more. Poles due to global. Pole. The North Pole, South Pole. Arctic, Antarctic. Everyone give the answer. Okay, next. Next. Okay, so that means three. Okay, Arctic. Okay, so next, coral reefs. Oh, which is the correct answer? Arctic. Oh, okay, okay. Okay. Next. Okay, the last question. Finished, done. Okay, next. Then you'll see your score. Okay, so when your class, when you stop your class, you have few minutes, and then you have your score. Okay, then you've got your leaderboard. So that's how this engagement of the class. Now, suppose that day somebody asked me, can you convert this? Okay, can you convert? You can go to the Kahoot Zool, Kahoot thing, and then you can see the report, Lapper, the reports, report, the Lapper. Okay. Actually, Kahoot is used for fun, but if you want to get a report, you can actually get it from here. Okay, so download. You can download or you can view. Okay, see, so you can use the Kahoot in the class. So that day, the lecturer asked, "Can it be used for assessment?" Of course, you can, but you need to inform the student that you'll be assessed for so many marks, and you need to upgrade your table for table. That's very important. Okay, so now you can see all. Now the thing is, the Kahoot. So you can, the Kahoot is giving you problem. So you see quiz one, Kahoot summary, good summary, final score. So you got your final score, right? You can mark, you can convert to mark if you have your rubric. Now the thing about the Kahoot, the good thing is tells you which part they understood and which Kahoot summary is, and then go to quiz one, Kahoot summary. So in this, right, you can see which ones they got wrong. So if in the classroom I told you all, global warming is affecting and the major gas is so and so, blah, blah, blah. And then at the end I know, they didn't understand that part. So then I recover again. So Kahoot is usually given in the middle of a lecture. Usually you have it in the middle of a lesson plan. So Kahoot is very good. You can create your own Kahoot if you all want to learn. I can show you all. But so I just wanted you all to have some fun in the class. So you'll use Kahoot. So Kahoot can be created very easily. It's just a drag and drop. I can show you all if you all are interested. Do you all want to see how it's done? Or is it? Are you all okay with it? You want to see how it's actually constructed? The Kahoot? You want to see how it's constructed? Is it okay, Dr. Bhaktiya?
Yes.
Okay. So I just, this is something which you can use to engage students. Now, all you need to do when you, are you all logged into Kahoot account? Okay. So all you need to do is click on the create button.
Create button.
Okay. Create. Okay. The create button. And it says create new.
Create new.
You can create new, you can use existing template. Kahoot allows you to modify existing one, but always to create new. Now, Kahoot has got templates for each type of function. You can teach with Kahoot, which is teach with slide, which means you show the first slide, the student watches the first slide, and then you can Kahoot them. You can ask them questions, and then you can go on to the next slide. You can do that as well. So that's teach with slide. So one of the most widely used is formative assessment. So it tracks, the one which we did now is actually formative assessment. So now you can see the Kahoot is developed by educators for educators. So you can see their structure, okay? So select one. Get to know your teacher is about your personality, but mostly this is the useful one. One used most widely, formative assessment. Click. Okay, so now everything in this, right, is basically drag and drop and plug and play. There's no programming, nothing involved, okay? So if you see the structure, right, you will see, so we'll go slide by slide. So you want to, you have to put an introductory question first. Then you have a quiz. Usually the Kahoot is easier at the beginning, becomes difficult in the center, and then becomes easier at the end. That's the formative, that's the way they structure the Kahoot, the educators plan. So you have a simple and complex, so it goes up to true quick, and then it becomes challenging, more challenging, and then becomes easier. So that's the way it does the Kahoot. Okay, so these are the slides. So it uses slideshow format. Let's go to the first slide, Zul. You can also put in video. Okay, go to the first slide. Okay, I will just show you the functionality. So to change this, just click and change. Okay. To change the image, so that's the basic function. If it's a mathematic question, you have the access to the mathematic formula library. Everything there. You have integration, differentiation, whatever, statistical, summation, everything, math, click math. You have everything there. Double integral, differentiation, all the codes. You can even have, okay, cancel. Okay, so that's the first one, this one. The second thing is the timer button there. The timer is already set. You can set your time. You can just choose. So easy question, difficult question, you select your timer. Usually don't select 5, it's too slow because of our network. It'll go down. And then this one, to remove. Okay, so you can go to the image library. You can put, okay, image library will give you, Kahoot has an image library. If you want your specific subject, like you have a picture of a plant or a flower or some cell or mushroom, you can upload that directly into the system as well using upload. Yeah. So you can ask the student, okay, this is a picture of something, what does it mean? Okay, so go back, but just add random, so the mountain you can add. Okay, so that add the picture inside. Okay, so you can add the picture. And then these functions, of course, are premium paid. Okay, now comes the Baba. Okay, it gives you 4 answer, so you can just put. So it tells you, it even tell you the pedagogical aspect. So this is the plausible answer, silly answer, incorrect and correct. Okay, it gives you the 4 choice. So plausible means, okay, what is that? Suppose I said, what is that? Question says, what is this? What's in the image? What is the image? What is the image? What's in the image? Okay. You'll have fun with it later playing. Okay. So I put the correct answer is mountain range. Okay, so you have everything done, mountain range, and then I put here something else. So it basically selects. So if in your class, right, if everyone gave silly answer, means they are not paying attention. That's the way to interpret the Kahoot. But suppose they give a plausible answer, that means they are thinking. So you can predict lots of things by. So it's designed for the educational. Okay, incorrect answer. You just put okay. So. Okay, save, exit, done. Okay. So once everything is done, you just click done and you can play. So I give you all can play with it and done. Just click done. Just click preview done. So it'll allow you to preview and done. Okay, so done. So exit. Log out. So Kahoot is one tool which you can use, and then you have another function. I'll tell you. One last function I'll tell you. Okay, now suppose I'm doing my Kahoot. Okay, I do my Kahoot. Do any Kahoot, Zul? The Kahoot, just click on my Kahoot for formative assessment. Okay, suppose I have my edit it. Blakang. Just go to edit. Go to Blakang, Zul. The back. Edit. Okay, now suppose I created the Kahoot, right? I have created this Kahoot, for example, see. Okay, suppose I created a Kahoot for a course, okay, and I ran out of question. I don't know, I ran out of idea. You have got question bank. Click here, question bank. Okay, I want to add a question on, for example, on mountains, tallest mountain in the world. Tallest mountain in the world. Okay, you can make a quiz. You can make a quiz using existing question created by others. So you can, for example, you have tallest mountain in the world, tallest mountain in Japan, tallest mountain in Thailand, tallest mountain. You can make the quiz on tallest mountains in the world just by adding from the other questions. The question bank created by others. So this is the way you use the basically aggregated knowledge, which is aggregated from different sources in the Kahoot. Okay, now Kahoot is very popular. So you can just add the question, you can add tallest mountain in the world, which is the tallest mountain in the world, and then you have add. You just add anything, and it's done. Close. Yeah. Close. Just close. It's okay. So you can make a quiz on mountain, Kahoot, you publicize, you produce it, and you'll find many people around the world suddenly playing your Kahoot. So Dr. Bhaktiar's Kahoot is played in Africa and America and Thailand, wherever, because it handles mountains. So basically, actually it's very fun, but this is actually engaging learning using emotion. So the student actually, based on the gamification theory, the student has to engage emotionally. So Kahoot uses the emotion to engage the student rather than the, so it gives you a reward, okay? So that's Kahoot, okay? Okay, so we just done, we just log out. So I hope you all can use the Kahoot to play. Of course, it's a paid version, but it's free for reuse. Why not? Are you all trying that? Are you all doing the Kahoot?
Oh,
but it's fun, right? It's fun. It's engaging. So you're, suddenly the lecture is so serious and you remove the Kahoot and then suddenly everyone engaged. So there are two types actually. One is Mentimeter, but Mentimeter is also paid, but Mentimeter only gives you 3 slides. Mentimeter, so you can do poll in the class. Have you understood the topic or you just poll? Then you know. So if you have very big class, right, 100 students, and did you understand the concept, or did you just give them a question, which is trick, they will answer yes. Then, but actually they didn't understand. But so you do a trick. So you check Mentimeter, then means you have to go back.
Mentimeter.
But don't use that. It's in our network. It's a bit slow in our UMS network. This one, okay. This one is okay. Mentimeter, because they only allow you 3 slides, and sometimes in some classroom we have problem access, Wi-Fi access issue. You can see Mentimeter, Prof. Vincent uses, but he has the paid version, which is allowing to put many slides. Paid version, yeah. Mentimeter. But for student, Kahoot is more engaging. I tried both, they prefer Kahoot. There are many gamification platforms. Okay, now suppose you want to add the Kahoot into your web page, you have to add it as an embed inside your web page. So you inside your Smart 2, you don't embed it directly. You can add an activity or resource, and then you add you go down to page. Okay, add, and then you can add the web page to that. You use URL also. You don't embed. I'm afraid if you embed, it will become issue. Go to Blakangzo. Use the web page. The web. Go to URL. Okay. Go to URL. Don't add because it may embed and crash the system. Add because Kahoot is using the Java, so it may crash. Okay. So please refer to the website. Please log in to the Kahoot website using the code, and then you give the IT. Below that, please log in. Use URL. Don't use, because this is using Java. It may game. Okay, game for today. Game time. Okay, just please log in to the website using the game code. Okay, and then below that you put the kahoot.in. Go down to the URL. Kahoot.in. Because I'm afraid that if you use Kahoot embedded inside Smart 2, it's using Java and then it may crash the server. Kahoot.it. Sorry. Then done. Kahoot.it, right? Kahoot.it. Okay, Kahoot.it. Just close the valve. Okay, then save and display. Save and display. Save, and so the game time, they click and then they get the link. Click. So they will click and they will go. Don't do embedding, because embedding I'm afraid it may hang the system. Kahoot.it. Okay, so Kahoot, you can.